what the whole deal is here. Just trying to get this speech out that I had. So first off, when the music is playing, can we make sure that all our cell phones are turned off? That's the first thing, because especially I'm getting this this video tape right now. So that's the first thing. Next, this quartet is a string quartet, and it's a multi-movement piece. It has three parts. So usually when this kind of music is playing in a concert hall or something like that, you would not clap until the very end of the piece. So there's going to be two parts where they stop playing, and it's the end of that part. But it's not the end of the whole thing, okay? So I just ask you, just wait till the very end when they stop, and then they'll stand, and then you can applaud if you choose to do so. All right. First things first. I just want to start off by thanking everybody here at Outward Space for letting me do this. It's very kind of them to give me this opportunity. And it was, I appreciate it so much. You guys should check out this place more often if you get the chance, because they do tons of really cool stuff like this, like having exhibitions, or they'll show foreign films on some nights, as well as like musical events like this. And then, plus, Ray makes a good drink. There's always that. So thanks to them. Next, I want to thank these four for being just amazing musicians, and I've got to know them over the last basically month or so, and they've just been really great. They're amazingly talented. They're all from the Jeongyeon Inuit Shoyan, and so they're just some of the best young musicians we find in China today. So I was extremely happy for the opportunity to work with them on playing this. So quickly, a little bit about myself. Most of you here know me, so I won't go on about it too long. But I was born in America from a small town. In that small town, I had a history of kind of growing up with a lot of music in my life. I played in my high school's band program for many years, and I also did, you know, the kind of high school thing where you join a rock band and all that kind of stuff. But then when I went to college, I found out that I wanted to do composition, and so I kind of started on that path. After this, I had my, you know, recitals, and I did all that stuff. Then I came to China wanting to do a gap year before continuing for a master's in composition. But then I really liked it here. I liked China. I liked learning the Chinese language and the culture. I found it really interesting. And so stayed, and now I'm here, but I'm still a composer. And so let me talk a little bit about this piece now, and then we can get started. So this piece, I really enjoy a lot of the music that came out of the early 20th century. So like the music from like the 1920s, 30s, so composers from the Impressionists like Debussy, or for instance, some of the Viennese school people, because they were doing these really crazy things, like Schoenberg, then people like Stravinsky as well. I draw influence from a lot of these kinds of folks, but particularly one of the composers that I'm just really, the last two or three years I've been really obsessed with is Béla Bartók. I think Chinese is Béla Bartók, yeah. And I've just been kind of fascinated with him the last couple of years, and I think it really, you can really hear it in this work, because Bartók was always this composer where he, at least for me personally, it always seemed he had one foot in the past and kind of one foot in the future. He was, in his compositions, he would do these like crazy changes in time or tempo. He would do like a lot of new techniques that prior to Bartok, that for instance, there's a kind of pizzicato where she'll play the second movement where, you know how sometimes they go like this, but instead of just he snaps it back really hard and gets this really interesting effect. And then in terms of, he also still had his foot in the past with being very tonal at times, but at sometimes being very like noisy, very not pleasing sounding. So he was a composer who kind of walked this middle, this kind of like Tao Tao, East of the kind of thing, where it's just he's got this part of him and this part of him, but he kind of walked down the middle. And I, compositionally speaking, I just find that so interesting that you can do this really kind of like crazy out there stuff, but also have a foot into the more traditional, beautiful, harmonic kind of thing. The first movement is a faster movement. It's a scherzo. And this one, basically, in 2014, when I came to China, I would work on some compositional things. And then in 2015, I just made some sketches for my string quartet. And then later on, I decided I wanted, oh, I actually want to do a string quartet. And I looked at the first things that I wrote, and I just thought, oh, this is awful. Just like, this is so bad. But then I actually found out like a few little pieces that I actually thought, okay, this is serviceable, or I actually kind of like this, and I just kind of threw away the rest and started from there again. So this first movement is actually mostly from that kind of very, very beginning part that I developed. It's very fast. It's it can be a little bit dissonant at times, but in the middle section, it's much more traditional. It's much more kind of pretty. The second movement is, this one's a little bit more slow and contemplative, but towards the end, it does get quite noisy and interesting. The second movement, I think, has the most kind of experimental, not necessarily experimental by today's standards, but in the sense that it's not, some of these techniques are something not you would hear every day in the concert hall, unless you were listening to a lot of contemporary classical music. So for example, there's going to be the pizzicato I talked about. Also, towards the end of that movement, there will be an aleatoric section. And what aleatoric music is just a fancy word for saying like chance music. So instead of writing down specific notes, I give them a set of notes to choose from in this part, and then they can choose how to play it in that part. So it's composition, but it's also improvisation at the same time. And then finally, in the third movement is much more romantic in terms of its traditional, like romantic, late 19th century kind of tonality, although it does have a lot of the kind of changes in speed that you can find in some of those Bartok pieces that I mentioned. So basically, that's kind of what I'm expecting you guys to hear tonight. So I'm so glad it came, and I'm hoping that you will enjoy the piece. Cell phones are off, like I'm doing with my cell phone right now.